God. A very warm good morning and a hearty welcome to all. The kingdom of God is peace in the Holy Spirit. He will reign in you if your heart is at peace. So be at peace and you will honor in a sovereign way the God of peace and love. So I would like to call prayer group with a prayer song to pray to God and bring His blessings. I request everyone to stand for prayer.
Celebrating Feast of Patron of De Paul School, St. Vincent de Paul. I express my pleasant greetings by wishing you all a very happy feast. All of us know a small portion about the life of our patron saint. Today we are celebrating the death anniversary of St. Vincent de Paul. Some of you may think, why we celebrate his death anniversary, not the birth anniversary? Dear friends, his life was full of risk at that time, but his faith in God was very strong. He was a Catholic priest born on 24th April 1581 and he died on 27th September 1660. He spent his whole life and time for poor people. He founded religious societies. He provided food and comfort to the poor. He had shared compassion, humility, kindness, love and wisdom with others, which is not to be forgotten. To remember these kind deeds, we celebrate this special day today. Though he is not present physically here, we have his followers to carry out his missions. We have our father who are inspired by energy and passion, and also their hard work and loving service is appreciated all over the world. The priest of Vincent Young congregation draws the spirit and different character from the life and works of Saint Vincent de Paul, who is chosen as the father and patron. Therefore, he is the patron of de Paul schools. Let us thank God for such a lovely presence of our school fathers. We are also inspired by school fathers' passion, love, humanity, patience, caring, understanding. Above all, their faithfulness to God in carrying out their great work of God's in Yehova. By giving students good education, especially giving good moral values, characters, formation to face the future challenge of life and much more. We are extremely happy to have your presence with us, fathers. So, I hope you all are enlightened by the facts. So, let's move on towards felicitation. It is said, welcoming people in a part of culture followed for centuries. Welcoming people is a part of culture followed for centuries. We maintain this custom and I heartily welcome all for feast celebration. It is time to honor and welcome the dignitaries present over here today. I request Borsi sir to please welcome our principal Father Matthew with a small token of love. Give a big round of applause. I request
Lucky sir to please welcome Father Santo with a small token of respect.
Thank you once again. A happy feast to all of you.
Thank you ma'am for your thoughtful welcome speech. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. Yes, you are right Asmita. Same way, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. So now, here I would like to call dear principal Father Matthew, vice principal Father Santo, to light the candles to illumine our minds. For being the champion of sweetness and goodness. I love it, you love it, everyone loves it, isn't it? Sure, cake cutting. It is one of the most delicious part of the event because happiness starts here.
The storm comes your way, clearly here for a brighter day. Saints and sailors, watch over you.
Thank you.
it's indeed my pleasure to call dear little man to speak few words about our patron saint, Vincent de Paul.
A blessed good morning to everyone. Respected Principal Father Matthew, Vice Principal Father Sandu, sisters, teachers and my students. It is his good pleasure that we remain always in the holy joy of his love. These are the words of great saint, the patron of all charitable activities, Saint Vincent de Paul. Today, with all dignity, we de Paulians celebrate the feast of our heavenly patron, Saint Vincent de Paul. At the very outset, I wish you all the heartfelt greetings of the day. Saint Vincent was a saint of the 17th century and a saint for the 21st century. He was born to a poor family in the French village on 24th April 1581. From his childhood onwards, he had a special care and love for the poor. After becoming as a priest, he visited the slums, the prisoners and the poor people of the outskirts of the country and listened to their complaints with great patience. He symbolized with their sufferings and provided financial and spiritual help for their empowerment. He encouraged them to face all the difficulties and pains and established a number of orphanages, old age homes and hospitals. This generosity made him a champion of the poor, and that's why people called him the father of the poor. Saint Vincent had a great concern for nature too. An incident that happened when he was into his last hours of life. Doctors prescribed a medicine to save Vincent de Paul that was to be prepared with the blood of a dove. But he refused to take that medicine in order to save that innocent dove. The simple action inspired all those who were present there. On 27th September 1660, he was taken by angels to heaven. Dear friends, today the world is running after fame and wealth. People are shrinking in themselves by boosting one's own interest. This selfish mentality keeps the neighbors aside. Many of us are not conscious about things that are happening around us, and very often we ignore the needs and worries of the people around us. Here, the life of Vincent de Paul stands as a challenge before us. His life teaches that we are here in this world not only for our own needs, but to live for others. If you are rich enough, then share it with needy. If you are very intelligent, share our time with the ignorant ones. If you are in supreme positions, spend our time with the downtrodden and the poor people. Saint Vincent's life put us before a simple logic to become a man of God. Today, we take this occasion as an opportunity to recognize and appreciate the goodness, dedication and commitment of our fathers, Father Matthew and Father Sandro. Let us do simple things in extraordinary ways, then the rest will be a great history. Once again, I would like to take privilege to say happiest feast to Father Matthew and Father Sandro. Lastly, I would like to wish you all happy feast. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher, for your valuable words. My feet are moving. Are it yours?
Yes, mine too.
Now hold your breath to see the rocking performance of our young dancers.
Come on, give a huge round of applause and welcome them on the stage.
Come on.
Winning is great, sure, but if you are really going to do something in life, the secret is learning how to lose. Nobody goes undefeated all the time. If you can pick up after a crushing defeat and go on to win again, you are going to be a champion someday. Yes, here we have champions who had presented their talent. Let's have a big round of applause for all the participants in all categories. To present the prizes of position holder, I request Kishore sir to be on the stage.
Good morning everyone. Today it's a great day for me to announce the winners of competitions of our school for the year 2020 and 2021. I would like to call our principal, Father Matthew, please come forward to give away the prizes to our students. Please, Father.
We dance for laughter.
We dance for tears.
We dance for madness.
We dance for fears.
We dance for hope.
We dance for screams.
We are the dancers. We create dreams.
Please welcome little Dipolius with a huge round of applause for the dance show.
Someone We must love our neighbors as being made in the image of God and as an object of His love, Saint Vincent de Paul. Respected Father Santo, respected sisters, teachers, parents, and my dear children. Today is September 27th. The Catholic Church remembers the great saint of charity, Saint Vincent de Paul. Let me take this opportunity to give the wishes of the day. Where do we go to see God? Do we need to sit on a mountain top to experience God? Do we need to go to a cave or close our eyes? There are many ways to understand God, such as God realization, self realization, through religious teachers, temples, etc. But I feel the best way to experience God is to look deeply into the eyes of another person. Look beyond personality, go deeper than his or her intellect, and see pure life energy, which is God. It can be explained with a Tamil word, Uyir Uyir. God is the life of our life. According to Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, he who knows God as the life of life, the eye of eye, the ear of ear, the mind of mind, he indeed comprehends fully the cause of all causes. In Indian culture, every time we greet another person with a traditional gesture of namaskar, we have the opportunity to practice looking deeply enough into his or her eyes to see God. The deepest meaning of namaskar, which means I greet God in you. According to Christianity, God loves us with such an incredible love. He wants us to experience incredible life-changing love, mercy and compassion, not only from him, but from those around us. Blessed are those who have regard for the weak. The Lord delivers them in the times of trouble. Psalm 41:1. If anyone says, I love God and hates his brother, he is a liar. For one who does not love his brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. 1 John chapter 4 verses 20. Helping and supporting those in distress is a trait that is encouraged by Islam. Muslims' primary goal is to worship God, but this is done not only through rituals like prayer and fasting, but also through the treatment of other people. There is a clear reward for a person who aids another, both in this world and in the next. If you help anyone, Allah helps you. Guru Nanak taught that God is within all people, and therefore serving people is serving God. Seva towards all people, especially those less privileged or underserved, is a key goal set for all the Sikhs. Seva should be practiced without any thought for a reward. Rather, it is a part of one's duty as a person to do good for others and for the community. The Sikh holy book, the Guru Granth Sahib, states that you become like the one you serve. In other words, to become one with God, service is required. All the religions in the world teach us to see God in the eyes of the needy. Saint Vincent is a great saint of all charitable activities. According to Saint Vincent, poor people are our masters. He used to encourage others to see Jesus in poor and sick people. If a person visits a sick man 10 times in a day, he visits God 10 times. Saint Vincent taught his followers to have adjustments in the matter of prayer if they really serve poor. He was influenced by the words of Saint Francis Sales, leave God for serving God, which means avoid prayers in order to serve the poor people. Saint Vincent de Paul did the works of six saints. He is the inspiration for more than 200 congregations in the world. He is considered as the patron of all charitable works. Catholic Church got many saints and servants of God because of the holiness of Saint Vincent de Paul. There are many universities, schools, hospitals, churches which adopted Saint Vincent as their patron. Let us look deeply into the eyes of poor people and see God in them and serve them as if we are serving God Himself. May God bless you abundantly. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. That was indeed motivating and extremely informative. Hey, Asmita, do you think a person can convey the message without speaking?
Yes. Why not? Here we have got a mime performance. Let's see.
शरीर मर जाता है पर आत्मा जीवित रहती है। लेकिन आजकल के समय में देख रहा हूँ कि शरीर तो जीवित है परंतु आत्माएं मर चुकी हैं। जरूरी नहीं कि जिसमें सांसी नहीं वही मुर्दा है, जिसमें इंसानियत नहीं वो कौन सा जिंदा है। इंसान की इंसानियत उसी समय खत्म हो जाती है जब उसे दूसरों के दुख में हंसी आने लगती है। गिर रहा है दिन ब दिन इंसानियत का स्तर और इंसान का दावा है कि हम तरक्की पर हैं। ऊंचाई चौखटों की लाख बढ़ा लीजिए, कद तो इंसानियत से ही बढ़ता है। खत क्या लिखा इंसानियत के नाम पे, डाकिया गुजर गया पता ढूंढते ढूंढते। मिट्टी के घरों में लोग खिदमत में खड़े होते हैं, औकात में भले ही छोटे हों मगर इंसानियत में बड़े होते हैं। इंसानियत बहुत बड़ा खजाना है, उसे लिबास में नहीं इंसान में तलाश करो।
जिंदगी है सरगम बजने द साजों की धुन, हर एक नया पल उम्मीद की है किरण, कोई है सहारा कोई है खुद में मगन, दर्द किसी का एहसास में है चुभन, जिसको मिले ना यह जिंदगी के दामन में खुशियां नहीं आंसू मिले, कैसा गुरबत का जहां कैसा कोई जीवते सजा के लिए।
अगर आप किसी गरीब को एक रोटी देंगे तो आप उसका पेट शायद एक दिन के लिए भरेंगे, लेकिन वहीं अगर आप उस गरीब को रोटी कमाना सिखा देंगे तो आप उसका पेट जिंदगी भर के लिए भर देंगे।
ऐसा भी जहां है
that kindness is the language which deaf can hear and blind can see. Love and kindness are never wasted. They always make a difference. They bless the one who receives them and you the giver. Be kind for everyone you meet is fighting a hard battle. When you do an act of kindness, they will remember to be kind to someone else and it will become like a wildfire.
Wow, it was great.
I hope everybody got the message, help the poor.
Now here comes Radhika ma'am with speech on our patron saint, Vincent de Paul.
A very good morning to one and all present here, respected principal, Father Matthew, Father Santo, sisters and all my dear friends. Today we all have gathered here to celebrate our patron's day. In this auspicious occasion, I am very glad to say a few words about Saint Vincent de Paul. Saint Vincent de Paul was born in a poor peasant family. He became a French Roman Catholic priest who declared himself to serving the poor. Because of his hard work and initiative, many poor people could come to the mainstream of society. He was renowned for his compassion, humility and generosity, and he is known as the great apostle of trumpet. He is the patron of all works of charity. Our school also in the name of Saint Vincent de Paul, which give education to middle class children and do a lot of charitable work. And we also follow the same message of Saint Vincent, that is the upliftment of the poor. We know that our fathers and old Vincentian congregation always committed with the upliftment of the poor and does a lot of hard work, which is inspired from Saint Vincent de Paul. All services we get from Vincentian Mission Society is praiseworthy. We hope the coming year also God will bless us with all prosperity of progress in the name of Saint Vincent de Paul. Thank you. I wish you all happy feast.
Thank you, ma'am, to enlighten our minds with the great thoughts of Saint Vincent de Paul.
Thank you is best prayer that anyone could say.
So I request our little angels to perform thanksgiving dance.
Thank you. There's so much towards me. Roz dekha de jaye kuch naya, ya duniya haathon pe rakh de. Thanks a lot, lots and lots. Many ways just to say thanks a lot. Subah ho ya shaam, chahe jo bhi ho, kaam hoga pehle bas tumhara naam. Thanks a lot, lots and lots. Many ways just to say thanks a lot. Har panne pe ho ek nayi kahani, har el ko happy hum kare. Har baat ki de de chhoot, har din koi tohfa cute, jo bhi ho saath na chori. Thanks a lot, lots and lots. So many ways to say thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, lots and lots. Many ways just to say thanks a lot.
Good morning, one and all present here. First of all, I express my joy in wishing you all a very happy feast. Gratitude is like a bell. Until it rings, it has no meaning. So here I stand to ring the bell of gratitude. First of all, my sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's event a grand success. By His blessings of grace, we are able to make the event what it was. Respected Reverend Father Matthew, Reverend Father Santo, sisters, teachers, and my dear students, It's my great privilege to say vote of thanks on this occasion of feast of patron Saint Vincent de Paul. I would like to thank Father Matthew and Father Santo who has spent their valuable time and celebrated the feast with us. Thank you very much, Fathers. Now I thank Sister Hemima and Sister Deepika who gave us idea to celebrate a feast. Special thanks to our students who have given beautiful performance for this occasion. I thank all our teachers who have taken interest to make this day a joyful and colorful one. Thank you, dear teachers, for your hard work. I also want to thank the people who work behind the scene to execute stage setting, technical arrangementing, and non-teaching staff. This type of incident cannot happen overnight. The wheel starts moving about a week ago. It requires planning and bird's eye for details. We have been fortunate to be supported by a team of very active and dedicated teachers to our organization who are well versed in their jobs. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Trishni ma'am. Now, I would like to end this program with the lines by one of the greatest philosophers of all time, Socrates. The only good is knowledge and the only evil is ignorance. So, I would like to thank all of you for being a part of this event. Thank you one and all and have a great day ahead.